So today we're going to talk about vocabulary learning. Vocabulary learning is somehow tedious, boring. I hate memorizing vocabulary because it's just boring, especially when you have to memorize from a word list. Some teachers would suggest students to just read more. When you learn vocabulary while reading, this is called incidental acquisition. So past research has shown that the number of the word that is seen by the learner determines whether or not he or she remembers this word or retain it long term. Our question for today is, does extensive reading help vocabulary acquisition? Professor Horst did a research on second language vocabulary acquisition through extensive reading. So today we're going to look at the research and its results. You see? My cat. So Professor Horst did a research on students learning second language vocabulary through extensive reading. And today we're going to look at the research and its results and see what the learners can take away from the research. So, let's get started! 21 adult ESL students at a community center in Montreal were chosen. They took a 100-item pre-reading word knowledge test before they started their extensive reading program. 50 words are words that the learner should have known, along with 50 unfamiliar words that are more likely to be learned from the reading instead of other sources. After the program started, students choose books of their level and interest. Upon finishing the reading, the participants took another 100-item post-test to test their vocabulary growth in 6 weeks. So now let's look at the results. All the participants got a higher score on the post-test after the extensive reading program. They learned about 17 new words throughout the 6 weeks, and 10 of the words are from the 50 unfamiliar words, which means that they acquired these 10 words through the extensive reading. So from this research, we can conclude that extensive reading does help the acquisition of new vocabulary. And now we can think about what the learners can take away from this research. Number one, learning 17 new words from a book throughout 6 weeks, I would say it's not a really promising way to learn vocabulary. So if you're looking for rapid growth in your vocabulary, extensive reading might not be the best choice. But extensive reading has another benefit. It is that you can recognize frequently seen words more quickly. In other words, you could increase your reading speed. This is what a lot of people want, and you can do this through extensive reading. Extensive reading helps you increase your reading speed. At the same time, you can learn vocabulary incidentally. Number two, another question is that, are the students going to remember these words learned from the reading in the long run? So reviewing is still a really important part. In this research, the post-test was given to the students right after they read the book. Maybe that's why they scored really impressively. Anyways, if you want to remember a vocabulary for a long time, you still have to review, not just read extensively. Number three, the most important takeaway is that when you want to read extensively, try to find a book that is of your level and also a topic that you're interested in. In this research, all the participants read something that they're interested in and that is of their level. I think that also helped them acquire vocabulary incidentally because you would have the momentum to keep on reading instead of feeling lost or feeling not being challenged at all. So picking the right book is really important when you try to read extensively. There is no clear conclusion regarding to the number of the encounters for vocabulary acquisition, which is not surprising because it really depends on the reader's language proficiency and other factors. For example, if the new word is not lexicalized in the learner's first language, which means that in the learner's first language, there is no equivalent or direct translation of the word, it may make it kind of difficult for the learner to remember what it means. So there are many factors that contribute to incidental acquisition. But what we can learn from this research is that extensive reading has more benefits than incidental vocabulary acquisition. So this is pretty much it for this video. There would be more videos about second language acquisition research that's coming up. So stay tuned. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the like button if you like it. I would link all the references that I used in this video down in the description box, so go check it out if you're interested. I think that's pretty much it, isn't it? Okay, I gotta say bye.